Hi everyone, we'd love to wish you a happy new year. We'd like to thank you for all your comments and support. We've learned so much about the artists that we're reacting to and will continue to react to in the future. We'll be getting back to our reaction videos next week, but today Makeda and I will be interviewing each other about our own original music and the creative process. We will each be discussing and playing two of our latest music videos. We hope that you enjoy the interview and the songs. Please leave your comments below. We always appreciate your comments and we'll respond to as many as possible. With that said, let's get started. So, Makeda, your song Time, I've noticed it's filmed like in a beautiful studio and it kind of looks like you're in the creative process. How was it writing the song for you?
It was really a really great experience. I actually wrote it with my guitarist and we kind of mixed our feelings about people into it. And we were feeling like in some relationships we kind of have to be more honest with each other and ourselves, yeah. And that we kind of have to stop acting like there's no problem. Then we filmed recording the song in the studio. That was really nice.
That's so cool. I think that's a really nice touch. I think this would be a good time to actually play the song. So let's have a watch of the song.
Look at me now, picking up all the pieces that you left for me somehow. And you never know, 'cause you made yourself believe that it was not your fault. So you better go. Don't tell me to breathe or to relax my soul. So you better go. Don't tell me to breathe or to relax my soul. So you better go. Look at me now. All we built and all we had was meant to fall, 'cause we didn't care. Learn my lesson now. I was fighting not to see that you're a part of me.
Makeda, Time is a breakup song about realizing when it's time to move on. So first of all, what made you write the song, and were you drawing from any particular personal experiences?
I must say that it's a while ago that we wrote the song, but I think the song was kind of more inspired by my guitarist's story, and I just could really feel his pain. And since we're best friends, and it was someone really close to him, not even necessarily a romantic relationship, but it was someone really close to him that like deeply abandoned and hurt him. So yeah, since we're best friends, we kind of felt the same way about it. But I think in the course of the years, it's kind of also become my story a little bit, because I have one or two relationships that didn't feel quite honest. So
right.
Yeah, it was just working through those emotions of being left alone.
It's such a common thing, isn't it, that everyone can relate to. There's not really one person that can't relate, whether it's romantic or a friendship, like you say. But that's really cool, because that's showing that your empathetic side is quite strong. Like you can feel his emotions, and you're able to kind of put it into words. So that's really cool. What do you mean when you say, "Don't tell me to breathe or to relax my soul"? Because that's a really cool line.
Yeah, you know, the funny thing is, I feel like it's a very current feeling. Sometimes people keep telling you to calm down. They keep telling you to not to overreact, and to take things, I don't know. Sometimes we're really emotional about stuff, and people keep telling us to calm down. It's not that bad, and they don't validate our feelings. And
I think It was that feeling of, okay, stop telling me that what I'm feeling is not a reality, and let's confront it and let's talk about it.
That's so true.
Yeah.
That makes so much sense. People are always trying to, it's like a societal thing, isn't it? They just, oh, you mustn't cry in public. You mustn't behave this way. You mustn't show anger when you're bubbling up inside. And if you don't release it,
yes,
terrible things will happen. So yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Okay, cool. So you also have a lyric that goes, "All we built and all we had was meant to fall because we didn't care."
Right.
So I'm curious about the word "we," because for most of the song, it really does sound like you're calling out that other person.
Yeah.
But then when you say "we," it's almost like you're taking part of the responsibility and part of the blame on yourself. Would you say that's the case?
Yeah, I think sometimes in relationships, people always act like the other one is always at fault. But I think it's also important to look at, what did I bring to the table? How did I cause this relationship to get to this point? I think it's smart to, you know, kind of reflect on what I did to, you know, make the other person feel alone, or how I contributed to the situation. So I think sometimes people break their relationship and then they go, oh, it's broken, it's your fault. But no one really took the time to say, okay, we didn't take care of each other. We didn't take the time to listen to each other, didn't take the time to speak to each other. So yeah. I kind of feel like it's both people's responsibility if it really goes down badly.
That's so true. And it just makes a lot of sense that you would start off in the mindset that most people are in of like, oh, it's you're the one to blame. But the fact that you've taken a bit of responsibility is like a reminder to everyone. So it's like a personal journey that you've been on, where you've come to realize that two people have a role to play in a relationship. And it's a reminder to all those people who are blaming everyone else for their problems, isn't it?
That is true. I mean, it's hard when you're in pain to also go, okay, what did I do? It's hard, and sometimes it can kind of be gaslighting to tell someone, yeah, you know, you have problems you have to deal with too. I guess there's always a time and place when to reflect on your own actions. But I think it's very important in every relationship that it happens.
Exactly. And for your own personal growth as well, isn't it?
Yes, right.
So you did mention before that it was your guitarist experience. So who wrote that line? Was it you? Was it him?
It was a great time in my band, because I used to write all the lyrics and I was really excited. And there was a point where the guitarist said, hey, I started writing a song and do you think we could work on it? And it's a very personal story of mine. And since we were best friends, we were talking about the situation anyway. And he had a few lines. He asked me to help him because my mom is from Trinidad and Tobago. So I grew up speaking English at home, but all of my band members are Germans who learn German as a second language. So sometimes then he was nervous because he wanted me to correct his lyrics. So we just worked on the lyrics together, but like the core sentiment and feeling of the song is his, I guess. But yeah, that's what makes collaboration so amazing.
It's a beautiful process, isn't it?
Yeah.
So the line, "I was fighting not to see that you're a part of me." Can you go a little bit deeper into that one for us?
Yeah. Well, I think sometimes in life, we get angry at people for things that are kind of also our own traits, like the things we don't love about ourselves, we hate about others. And I mean, in this context, they are also kind of very, very close, let's say, without wanting to like say who it's about, but they were very, very close. And somehow, you love the person with all of your heart, you love them and they are part of you. So you're kind of also battling yourself in some way, because otherwise you would just let them go and, you know, stop associating with them.
But yeah,
like cutting off your own arm and letting them go.
Yeah. So you kind of hate that they're a part of you, but you can't help it. There's nothing you can do about that.
Right, exactly.
And yeah. It's very relatable. It is very relatable.
Yeah, it was amazing writing it with him. And he's a great guy.
So, Makeda, let's move on to your second song. So let's go ahead and watch the video. This is "The Day I Loved You Most."
I'm holding on too long. Still sleep in your shirt, but the rest of you is gone. Trying to fill in the space that has your shape. Your memory's all over this place, but it doesn't matter. I'll forgive you even if I shatter all of our mistakes. I make them matter. I know that I could hate you, but I'd rather remember the day I loved you most. Remember the day I loved you most. Picking up the pieces of my mind, I'm so sick of healing while you seem to be fine. Running out of reasons why, but it's alright. I don't need your blessing to move on with my life, 'cause it doesn't matter. I'll forgive you even if I shatter all of our mistakes. They make us brutal. I know that I could hate you, but I'd rather remember the day I loved you.
Now, I was going to ask you if it had any relation to the other song, "Time," that we just talked about, because there is a line that says, "Picking up the pieces of my mind." And in "Time," you say, what do you say? "Look at me now, picking up all the pieces that you left." So I did think that maybe they were connected in some way, but obviously it's not your experience. So your guitarist was not involved in writing this song?
So I wrote the song, The Day I Loved You Most, for the Eurovision Song Contest, because I was in the pre-selection, in the German pre-selection to go to Eurovision in Israel that year. And I wrote it with a team of songwriters that are my close friends now. And I suppose, I think I've just been through that feeling of having to pick myself up after relationships have ended, after friendships have ended. I think it's a part of life. So yeah, it's not surprising it came up again.
I know, it just shows it just shows how universal the concept is, the idea that relationships with people can leave you in such a state where you feel broken. So I guess that's just a happy coincidence, but it really does sound like a continuation. That's why I asked. Okay. Yeah. So in the chorus, you say, all of our mistakes, I'll make them matter. And then in the last chorus, you change that and you say, all of our mistakes, they make us better. So there's like a powerful transition. It could be missed quite easily if you weren't like paying attention. And there's a lot to learn from, you know, times of hurt and turmoil and heartbreak. So is that really the message you were trying to get across in doing that? Did you do it deliberately?
Yeah, actually, yes, there was so much I wanted to put in the song. And I noticed that, similar to time, actually, there's always two people in a relationship. You can't always go out of the relationship and go, they hurt me and I'm not going to forgive them and they should be saying sorry to me and all of that stuff. It's just, sometimes you don't get that. You don't get the person coming back to you and you don't get them to say, I'm sorry. Sometimes you don't get them to understand how they hurt you. And sometimes the only choice you have is to say, okay, I'm going to remember what I loved about you. I'm going to try and let go of the things that I hated or that I didn't like about you. And I'm going to try and see what I did wrong and take responsibility for that. And I think that's really important because otherwise you just end up being really resentful and bitter. And I wanted to, you know, make sure that if all of this pain had to happen, I make the most of it. Like, I won't just go home and say, well, it's their fault. I'll use the mistakes and I'll learn from them and grow from my next relationships, even if this one might have been a fatality. You know,
it's so important, isn't it? That makes sense as well.
They only make us better if we learn from them. Otherwise, it's just painful.
Of course, and then you cause pain to other people moving forward in your life, which isn't fair on them.
Right.
So nobody wants to have to deal with somebody else's mess. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I like that. So much like with time, the song seems to be referencing the other person's transgressions. This is kind of what we were just talking about, isn't it? So you say, could you forgive us? As if you're asking the person to forgive you. Can you elaborate a little bit more on that lyric?
Yeah, I mean, we were kind of discussing that for a long time because the question was, do I walk away with my head held high and go, okay, I'll forgive you for all of the things you've done and I'll be really gracious? Or do I say, okay, can we forgive us? Can we basically forgive each other because we both contributed to this? And can we just forgive that we were younger, that we were maybe childish in situations? Can we forgive each other, basically? I think that we chose, can you forgive us? Us, the team that made this thing go to hell.
So it's not about being the bigger person. It's about being, it's like both of you deciding to heal each other and yourselves, if that makes sense.
Exactly, that would be the hope. But even if that doesn't happen, sometimes it doesn't happen like that. Sometimes you can get the other person to go, okay, you're right, I did this and you did that. Make up. Sometimes you have to forgive them even though they're not going to give, not even ask.
It's true, because then that's going to be their problem, but you know that you've kind of got it a bit out of your system, I guess.
Yeah, and you have to also forgive yourself. I mean, you can't only go, I'll forgive you for all of the mistakes you made, and go, yeah, well, I never made any.
It's so true. Yeah, I just wanted to quickly ask you, because watching the video of, I've seen the video of you performing live at the Eurovision, the pre-bit, I guess, where they choose the songs. That your vocal performance on that was just so emotional. Do you find that when you perform live, because it made me emotional in your music video as well, but when you perform live, would you say that the mood is that much more intense, that you just give it everything you've got?
Yeah, the funny thing is I made one or two mistakes live in the lyrics because I was so crazily overwhelmed by the whole situation, that because 3 minutes before I was on stage, there was this video clip of all of the things that I did with my band and how my family supported me, and I was really emotional. And then I was like, I was also really adamant about like promoting this message that forgiveness requires two people, and it also, you don't have to ask anyone else for permission to forgive the whole situation, basically. So I was really like emotional already, and then I started singing the song to so many people, and I knew it was also important in the sense of it would have been great to win, obviously. So there was so much racing through my mind, and then I just really got so emotional about the topic. I started going, I think I got it somewhere. But yeah, it was just, it was a great feeling, and I was totally in the moment.
Yeah, you definitely made the most of your moment. You could tell just from watching it. It was great. Honestly, I love both of these songs, and it's been such a pleasure speaking to you about them and hearing what they're about from the horse's mouth. So thank you, Makeda. tell the audience, where can we find you online?
You can find me on Instagram. I think if you just put Makeda Music, and on YouTube, on Facebook, and recently on TikTok. you can find me basically everywhere. I have a website, makeda.de. And if you put Makeda, you'll find me pretty quickly in Google. So find me everywhere.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. I hope you enjoyed that interview. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, share with your friends, comment below. If you want to hear any of Makeda's other music or watch her videos, the links will be in the description below. Take care. Bye.